Okay, we're with one of our very closest friends and one of the most helpful people I ever met in my life, Dr. Parmalee, the pasta doctor. And we had a lot of problems lately and a lot of controversy about the show, but I guess now that you say forgive and forget, you're not mad anymore, are you?
No, I think I'm ready to go to the board meeting of Double Helix and tell them my exact position. I think that they should understand where I am.
Okay, well, one thing about Doc, he always says, forgive and forget, right?
That's right.
Okay, thank you.
Baby, I'm good. Nothing I can do for you that's too tough for me. I put out a burning building.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Paul Shankman, and we're here in the home of Peter E. Parisi, a candidate for the board of directors of the Double Helix Corporation, which, as you know, runs the channel which Peter's show, Worldwide Magazine, appears on. We're here to ask him some questions about his candidacy. Funny guy, but yet you've decided to go after this very serious job. But why are you running for the board?
I feel that Double Helix is at a crossroads. The most important asset of Double Helix isn't the tape recorders or the cameras, but it's the volunteers. These are the backbone of Double Helix. Several weeks ago, some of the volunteers came to me and asked me to run. My first inclination was not to get involved, but they asked me in the strongest way to please help. So I threw my hat in the ring.
These are people who produce other programs for the channel?
People from the radio station and the TV station.
Why did they approach you? What did they think that you could bring to the board?
Well, a basic theme of our election is to free the airwaves. We would like to make Double Helix more involved with the community. We feel that sometimes the volunteers that come there offering their services are neglected or ignored. We want that to stop. We think that the volunteers, as I said, are the most cherished asset of Double Helix, and they should be put on a pedestal and respected and appreciated.
More so than the paid staff?
Paid staff are getting paid. Everybody needs something, some incentive to do anything. If you can't get money, maybe you can get recognition. But it's important that if you do anything, then you get something out of it.
Do you have some specific programs in mind that you'd like to see accomplished?
I would like to have Double Helix start a training program for underprivileged black youth up in the north section of the city. And I am planning to propose that we send Double Helix employees up to North St. Louis to train these youths, these underprivileged youths.
Train them in television technology?
Right, television and radio. Also, I feel that there aren't enough black people on the radio station. I'd like to increase their participation in it. After all, 40% of the city is black. but I don't think 40% of the radio station employees are black. Also, I'm very concerned about sexual harassment. We are very lucky that there's some very attractive girls that do work at Double Helix. And I want to see that they don't get harassed anymore, as well as gay rights. I would like to make sure that the gay people, there are plenty of gay people that are involved in WX, are also appreciated and recognized and protected.
If you're not elected to the board, do you intend to still be a strong voice at meetings and so forth?
WX means an awful lot to me. I care about it and I love it. And if something happens where I'm not elected, I will continue to treat Double Helix the way I've always treated them.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Open Mic Night at the Venice Cafe. I'd like to begin by introducing Marilyn Quayle's best friend, the Friendly Russian.
Yeah! Ladies and gentlemen, I just took a few minutes off the campaign trail. I've been traveling with Marilyn Quayle and George Peach and Bill Webster. And now I would like to say that there's a great organization in this town which we love, we care about. It's called the Double Helix Organization. Yeah! Double Helix, yeah! It's an organization for the people, by the people. But in the recent years, we've been concerned that it's becoming more and more of a clubhouse, sort of a clique of certain people, and only their friends and relatives, wives, husbands, get jobs on the radio, television.
I've noticed that.
We would like to put an end to all of this. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to bring up the man of the people, Pete Parisi. You may want to ask, who is Pete Parisi?
Who is he?
I just got to say one thing. Pete Parisi is a good American like yourselves. Pete! All right! Pete!
Thank you, Vladimir. As you know, I'm running for the board of directors of Double Helix. And this involves tremendous amounts of responsibility, and I want your support. I want your election to be my election. I want to do everything I can for everybody. If anyone has any ideas or anything they want, please contact me at 879-3002, and whatever you want, we'll do for you if you vote for me. We're thinking about doing some poetry readings on the station on Double Helix. And if I get elected, we're going to have a lot of Monday night poetry on Double Helix. And we're going to have a lot of beatniks on there. And we're going to have a lot of real cool bohemian type people there. It's going to be great. I want your support. And thank you so much for your support. Your tremendous applause is just overwhelming. Boy, isn't it amazing? Look at that applause. Thank you. Thank you. Take a picture of that applause, would you? Oh, isn't that amazing? Take a picture of that applause. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I really appreciate it. I really appreciate it.
Welcome, folks, to another KDNA Arty Calendar. Just get ready, pull up a chair to your radio, and listen to some great things arty happening in St. Louis for the next couple of weeks. I'm your congenial host, Chuck Lavoris. You're now into the Arty Calendar. Let's take a look at the lineup for this week. Down in University City, there's all kinds of arty things going on. And out in Ladue, the rich people have all kinds of fun plays for you to go to see. Down at the Grand Center, there's a whole bunch of little plays which two people will probably see, but you should go out anyway. And this is sponsored by a grant from all kinds of rich people. Oh, thank you very much. Oh, you're now in the middle of the Artie Calendar. Welcome to the middle. By the way, I'm Chuck Lavoris, your congenial host. And some personal favorites of mine coming up in about a week and a half. There's a great fiddle player who plays a trombone at the same time. He's going on down, well, down you know where, down to the St. Marcus Theater. It's really, really a fun time. Oh, please get out and see that. Please, 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 please. Oh, we're nearing the end of the Artie Calendar. Oh, one note that I have to tell you now, this is personally from Chuck Lavoris, go out and vote for that Pete Parisi for the board of Double Helix. It makes total arty sense. Don't forget, vote for Pete. Personal favorite of mine. And, well, I know you've enjoyed this arty calendar just as much as I have, but oh, alas, our time is coming to an end. But don't worry, there'll be another arty calendar along in another 15 minutes. So until then, this is your congenial host, Chuck Lavoris. Folks, this is Chuck LaForest, and we're back at the Artie Calendar again. I want to tell you about what a wonderful clubhouse we have here. I mean, radio station at KDHX. But you know, all hail program committee! Oh, no! Oh, program committee, help me! Help me, program committee!
From Worldwide Magazine, I'm running for the board of directors of Double Helix. I want your vote this election, please.
Okay.
Okay? Yeah, thank you very much. You got big muscles. Wow.
Thank you.
Wide World Magazine, where Marty at?
Hi, I'm Peter Parisi. I'm running for the board of directors of Double Helix. I want your support this election.
You got
please.
It.
Hi, how you doing? How you doing? Hi, how you doing? I am running up for the board of directors of Double Helix. I'm Peter Parisi. How you doing? Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. What's your name?
Steve is deaf. He has the lip read.
Oh, I'm sorry. Well, even though the deaf people can still vote, you don't have to hear me to vote for me. You can say it in sign language. Vote for Peter Parisi for the board of directors of Double Helix. Hey, how you doing, lady?
Hi, you should have been at the zoo. That's where everybody is.
What's at the zoo?
The baby elephant.
I saw the baby elephant. You watch Worldwide Magazine? We've had the baby elephant on our show. A couple weeks ago.
Boy, he looks this little there.
No, he's about as tall as you.
Ow.
You remind me a lot of the baby elephant. Listen, ma'am, come back here. I'm running for the board of directors of Double Helix.
You are.
And I promise that if I get elected, we're going to do a lot of things for senior citizens.
Tell me your name.
Peter Parisi. Parisi? Yeah.
You're not sure.
I'll tell you. Yeah. We're going to do a lot of things for senior citizens if I get elected.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. Hi, I'm running for the board of directors of Double Helix. My name is Peter Parisi. I'd like your support.
Sure.
Okay, are you a member of Double Helix?
No.
But you might be able to join.
Okay.
We're going to do a lot for senior citizens if I get elected.
Good.
We have a strong senior citizens plan.
Parisi.
Okay. A lot for senior citizens. We're trying to do a lot for senior citizens. I'm running for the board of directors of Double Helix, and we promise that if I get elected, we're going to do whatever else we can to allow illegal parking in front of supermarkets. So we won't be hassled anymore by the police. You can park here all day if I get elected. Hi, my name is Peter Parisi. I'm running for the board of directors of Double Helix. Nice to see you. Okay. And we promise that if I get elected, we're going to do a lot of things for kids, for young people, for real young people like you. We're going to have a lot of kids programs and a lot of children things and Bugs Bunny and all that kind of stuff. It's going to be great. Don't forget to vote for me in the upcoming election. Okay?
Okay.
Okay, thanks, kids. You don't get in trouble here, will you?
Okay.
Peter
How you doing? Pete Parisi, running for the board of directors of Double Helix. I want your support.
You got it.
Okay, we promised that we're going to do a lot of stuff for bearded people. We have a special plaque in our campaign. We're going to really help out bearded people that look suspicious like you.
Well,
we're going to stop you from being persecuted by society.
I do find society. You do a good job.
That cigarette really smoking down to the butt, man.
Yeah, it's expensive now. What are you doing? What are you smoking? Optimus.
Okay, carry on now.
All right, have a good one.
We'll take care of you. Just vote for me. Board of directors. Double the Alex. We promise we're going to do a lot for the Afro-Americans. That's one of our strong planks on our committee. So I want your support. Thank you very much. Hi, how you doing? We're going to do a lot for fat people. How you doing, pal? How you doing? Nice to see you. That's a pretty big band you have there.
It is, huh?
Are you handicapped?
Oh, yeah, I'm a handicapped.
What's wrong with you?
A ticker.
Oh, really?
A ticker.
Well, we promised at Double Helix, if I run for the board of directors, that we're going to do a lot. We have some special platforms and programs that we're going to do for handicapped people. So vote for me for Double Helix board of directors.
Here we get you.
Okay, thanks, pal.
Take care of it.
Okay, bye.
Double not make a misprint, though.
Okay. Don't have a heart attack in there. Oh, you! Hi, my name is Peter Parisi. I'm running for the board of directors of Double Helix. We want your support. Mike, could you get a good picture of her? Okay, he's actually getting a good picture. We have a special platform for beautiful girls. We're going to take care of them. We're going to stop you from being sexually harassed. You used to be sexually harassed a lot. Why not? You work?
Yeah, I work.
You work at an office?
Yeah.
Wait, oh, well you get you like the sexual harassment.
See you later.
No guys aren't pitching your butt or anything?
No.
If I pitch your butt now, will you hit me? You call the police? Okay, well, if you just hit me, I'd pinch it. If you're gonna call the police, I don't wanna get involved with the police. What's your name?
Beth.
Well, get a good picture of her, Mike. He's our photographer, Mike. Mike Perez. Doing a great job. Okay, well, I'm running for board of directors of Double Helix. And you know, when I become the board of director, I'm going to have a lot of power. And, you know, beautiful women like to hang out with men, with powerful men. So would you be interested?
I have a boyfriend.
You have a boyfriend? You can get rid of him. I can see you on the side, but well, you don't see him every day, do you? You live with him? Okay, you don't live with him. You don't sleep with him then every night. You only see him like 2-3 times a week. I could be the other 3 or 4 days. It's a great idea. You'll have prestige. You'll be going to all the inaugural balls and all this other kind of stuff. It'll be really white. Great. So Beth, you gonna think about it if I give you my number?
Oh, yeah.
Get in your right car here. Hold on a second. Well, I don't have any cards, but I'll call you later.
Okay.
Thank you, Beth.
My name is John Hertzborn, and I've known Peter Parisi since 1986. I've known him, and I think that if he's running for the board of Double Helix, I see no reason why he should not be on that board. This is the United States of America. This is a democracy. Pete's a little different. So is Bill Clinton. He got elected. Why can't this man get elected? Vote for him. He's different. A little diversity on the board always help. That's what the United States is. It's a melting pot of ethnic peoples. Pete is Italian. If you don't put him on the board, you got something against Italians, and that's not right. The Italians built this country. Remember Christopher Columbus, forget about Christopher Columbus, but they did a lot for this country. So Tony Rabato, the other guy, a lot of Italians, Mr. Ruggeri, Joe Vaccaro. And there are a lot of people out there who support the Italians, and if Pete doesn't get on the board, I would basically say it's a racist thing because he's Italian.
Hi, I'm Lori.
And I'm a member of Double Helix. And you know, I'm going to vote for Pete Parisi to get onto the board of directors because Pete really is worried about women's rights. He's really concerned about the women of St. Louis. And so, as a woman of St. Louis, I'm voting for Peter Parisi to get a seat on the board of directors of Double Helix.
I've known Pete Parisi for a long time now, and I think he should be the board of directors president for Double Helix Television. And I've known him for a long time, and he's a good man for the job because I did some time in Jeff City, 3 years, and I wanted, you know, all us ex-cons, we love everybody, you know, and everybody's in the penitentiary, we all love each other, you know, but we got to get along and shit. Excuse me, but I want to vote for Pete Parisi for the president of Double Helix Television because all of us ex-cons watch him when we're up there in jail and everything. But, you know, I'm out for a while and I'm still going to watch him. But.
Hi, my name is Ron L., sometimes known as Johnny Rabbit, and I want to endorse, what is that? Peter Parisi. Peter Parisi, my old friend of many years to the that board, the Double Helix board, and he ought to be on the board. Not really, I've known Peter Parisi for 23 years, literally. Why, it's the truth, and he is really a great guy, and he does a lot of good stuff. And nobody else has got a show like this anywhere else, and he should be involved in the board of Double Helix. Why hasn't he been on before? What's happened? Now's your chance to vote for him. He deserves your endorsement, your vote, or whatever you have to do to get him on the board, and then you're really going to see some action.
Yes, it's Peter Parisi, man of vision. Peter Parisi, the man of the hour. Peter Parisi, from a small town in New Jersey, son of a merchant. He sold women's garments by day, and by night instilled in Peter Parisi honor and values like family and love and togetherness and organization. Yes, a world without Peter Parisi in it would be a terrible place. And a board of directors without the firm guiding hand of Peter Elias Parisi would be a weak board indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, there can be no choice more noble, more important at this moment, at this juncture in our history, than to vote for Mr. Peter E. Parisi, the man of the hour, the man for the board of directors for the Double Helix Corporation. God bless her.
Hi, this is Peter E. Parisi. I know you know me as an entertainer, but I'd like to talk to you seriously today about my effort to run for the board of Double Helix. You know, several weeks ago,
members of Double Helix came to me and they asked me to get involved in the board of directors election. These volunteers asked for my help. Without the volunteers, we would have nothing. And with the volunteers, we have everything. And the biggest asset Double Helix has is not the tape recorders or the microphones, but the volunteers. And I am going to join with the volunteers in helping to free the airwaves and give the airwaves back to you, the people. Now, as you can see from this graph, membership complaints in Double Helix are way up. And as you can see from this next graph, that the membership of Double Helix is way down. And you can see from this next graph that the thefts at Double Helix are increasing. I'm very proud to say that I've worked closely with TCI Cable. We've been in contact with them and we've talked about them many times. And I'm very proud to announce that the public access station will be moved on April 1st to Channel 22. Also, the local origination station will be moved on April 1st to Channel 21. I think working with people to create a better environment is what the Board of Directors is all about. And I'm proud to do what I can. Now, I am very concerned, as we all are in the country now, with social issues of the day, especially gay people. And we must, at Double Helix, do what we can to protect their rights and to give them a nurturing environment of friendship and peace and prosperity. I'm also concerned about the black people. There's a graph to the black people. We must get more black people involved in Double Helix. Last but not least, we'd like to be concerned about women. We want to make a very strong statement against sexual harassment in any form at Double Helix. As you know, there's very many attractive women that work at Double Helix in the office, and we have to protect them from harassment at all costs. We have to also protect the corporation against executives trying to make jobs for their girlfriends. We must eliminate nepotism. A few years ago, they had what they called a nationwide search for a station manager of KDHX. A nationwide search. And you know who they hired? The executive director's boyfriend. She had a nationwide search, and then she woke up one morning, looked over in the bed, and she found her candidate for the job. This stuff must stop. We must hire people on merit, not on nepotism. But anyway, I hope you vote for me for the board of directors. If you know anybody that is a member, you might want to call them up and tell them to vote for me. But even if you disagree with me, I think it's important to vote. No matter how you vote, it's the American way. You must vote. Vote even if you don't know anything about any of the candidates. Long as you vote, then you're doing the right thing. And with that, I'd like to thank you for your time. And I hope in the future to have more of these fireside chats with you. Thank you very much.
ever concerned about sexual harassment. The Worldwide Magazine crew and cameras recently went to a politically correct Gloria Steinem rally in Clayton. And right now, we present a look at the beautiful women followers of Gloria Steinem.
Wait a second. This is the wrong footage here. These women would never wash dishes or sweep a floor. Come on, can we put the right footage on, please? Here are the women of Gloria Steinem now. The beautiful women of Gloria Steinem.
KSD, great classic rock without the hard rock and the Police, Driven to Tears. I hope that is not descriptive of your condition, although parents out there probably reach that situation daily. Anyway, I'm Radio Rich, and welcome to Rancho Richo, if such is the case. You can come here and find some peace and quiet and some good music and a chance to hear stuff you don't always get to hear every day. Like, for instance, maybe some new Neil Young. This is a title track from his current album. It's called Harvest Moon. On 93.7 KSD, classic rock station. Hey, worldwide viewers, this is Radio Rich. Pete, my friend Pete, has come to visit me in the KSD studios. I'm doing my show, playing some Neil Young right now. And Pete is running for the board of directors for Double Helix. And I've known Pete for a very long time, more than 21 years. And I've worked with him. He's been my program director in the past. And he knows broadcasting, both radio and television, extremely well. And he's a man, as you know, that can get things done. And he certainly produces a popular television show, Worldwide Magazine. You're watching it right now. And I'm going to vote for him for board of directors. And when you get your ballot in the mail, if you haven't already, if you're members of Double Helix, vote for Pete Parisi for the board of directors of the Double Helix Corporation. And thanks.
My name is Richard Mellor, and I'm the general manager of Jukebox 96 radio station. I heartily endorse Peter Parisi for a board seat on Double Helix Corporation.
Okay, hello, first of all, this is Dump Truck Dave Perry, and people have seen me on TV a lot. I've done a lot of stuff for Pete Parisi and Worldwide Magazine, but I usually play kind of a wild and crazy kind of guy, you know, and I do a lot of stupid things sometimes. But you people like to see it. We all enjoy it. But today I'm here on a serious note because something important's happening. You know, the political views of the country is changing. Everything's coming down to new management, new everything. And at the moment, Pete Parisi is running for the board of directors for Double Helix. And on a serious note, I want to tell all you people, all you members out there, if you have a chance, vote for Pete, because he's going to do a damn good job. I know, because I do a good job myself. But Pete Parisi's a man for the job, so if you can get him in there, please make the vote. We could use it.
And here are the beautiful girls from Simply Irresistible, 4519 South Kings Highway. And of course, these wonderful ladies have decided to help me in my campaign. We'll be talking to them today, and we'll be interviewing them, these young, very astute, politically active girls, promised to be the key to my impending victory. And we're at the Simply Irresistible on South Kings Highway, and one of the beautiful, young, lovely models from Simply Irresistible. What's your name?
Janie,
and how old are you?
19.
You're only 19? Oh, God. Hey, Mike, get a good picture of Janie. So what's new?
Nothing.
What would you want to say to our vast viewing audience?
Vote for Pete.
Oh, isn't that great? That's great. And believe me, if I get elected to the board of directors of Double Helix, there'll be ladies like this hanging around Double Helix 24 hours a day. Is that right?
That's right.
So why do you think you should vote for me as board of director?
Yeah, you're so handsome, Pete.
Thank you. And what is your favorite things to do?
I love to model lingerie.
Well, maybe we can get you to put some lingerie on?
No, I have to go. I don't have time.
Oh. Take some of this. I'll adjust it for you. I'll adjust it for you. No, I know a lot about not lingerie. I can adjust it for you. Get a good shot of adjusting it, yeah. I mean, are you into anything kinky?
No, I'm just always working.
Oh, are you into anything kinky?
Sure.
Like what?
Anything. Here's this nice whip.
Oh, you like to be whipped? has your boyfriend ever whipped you?
I don't have a boyfriend.
Why don't you have a boyfriend? A beautiful girl like you?
No.
Why not? You're too busy for boyfriends?
That's right.
Uh-huh. Have you ever been whipped? Have you ever been whipped before? You ever thought about being whipped? It might be fun. You might enjoy it. Let me tell you something. There's some problems with these girls, but on the whole, they're pretty good. If I get elected to Double Helix, I plan to whip this organization into shape. I think that we've seen a lot of ugliness during this campaign, and it's time to see some things and some people that are beautiful. What's your name?
Karen.
What's your name?
Christy.
Listen, I'm sorry, girls. There's only one of me to go around, so you'll have to split me up as best you can. Oh, what's your name?
Terry.
Mike, could you get a good picture of Terry?
Would you like to see the back?
Yes, I would very much. Yeah, okay. I plan to whip this organization, Double Helix, into shape once I get elected, and we're going to do it with women, beautiful women like this, from Simply Irresistible. Now, do you believe in heavy petting on the first date?
It all depends.
How old are you?
19.
You notice that everybody we've talked to here has been 19? Like, they're all 19.
Pretty much of us are.
You're 19. That's the magic number, 19.
Of course.
Right, you can't be 18 or you have to be 19.
You can be 18. 18 or older.
Mike, get a good picture of her, would you please?
John Cornetta, this is
Len Silcox.
We're the owners of Simply Irresistible. You know, we've been persecuted against by the city and by a lot of our neighbors, kind of in the same way that Pete Parisi has. And all we want to do is send out our sympathy for Pete. We know that he's been persecuted against because he's different and unique, kind of like us. What we want you to do is to go out there and vote, and a vote for Pete is a vote for us and a vote for these girls.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you. I'm glad I'm getting your support, and I'd like to support some of these girls. Do a Double Helix after I get elected to the board of directors.
I don't even know where it's at. I don't know. What is it? I don't know. Oh, I'd like to be your secretary, please.
Let me ask you something. You could do secretarial work?
Yeah.
Well, how are you with dictation? Now listen, I want you to stay, okay?
I'm sorry, Pete, I gotta go, Pete.
Well, listen, I'd like you to stick around here because something might pop up later. Now listen, do you believe in tongue kissing on the first date?
Seriously?
Yeah, I'm serious.
Yeah.
Well, are you doing anything next week, next Friday night? And don't forget, we'd love to hear from you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week at the Worldwide Magazine Viewers Hotline, 879-3002. 879-3002. Give us a call, leave us a message, and maybe we'll put it on the air. You're watching a special edition of Worldwide Magazine, Decision 93.
Hi, this is William Stage, columnist with the Riverfront Times, on behalf of Pete Parisi, who's running for a board seat for Double Helix. Now, Pete, you may know as a producer of Worldwide Magazine, that funny show on Double Helix, but in this bid for a board seat, Pete has the serious intention of getting the community volunteers more involved in Double Helix goings-on. I hope you vote for Pete because he's a good man.
I've been a member of Double Helix for many years, and I've never seen a finer candidate for board of directors than Pete Parisi and the PEP show. You're darn tootin'!
Hi, I'm Kathy. We're downtown today at the biggest parade St. Louis has ever seen for Pete Parisi. Pete is running for the board of directors at Double Helix. I want to tell you, this place has been crazy. It's been a madhouse. People are coming from all over the place. People are coming from Illinois. They're coming from Arkansas. Everybody's behind Pete. I've never seen a showing like this before, ever. Marty's with me. Marty, what do you think about the big crowd?
Well, I think it's the biggest and the best parade St. Louis has ever had.
Oh, it's huge. It's huge down here. And if you're at home, don't try to come down here. There's too much going on already. The highways are backed up. 55 is just crazed. 44 is the same way. You can't get off the highway anywhere. It's packed and everybody's here. Everybody from the show is here. Everybody from every show ever is here. I think I saw Milton Berle.
Yeah, Milton Berle and Doc Parmalee and Vince.
Doc Parmalee. Yeah, there goes Doc right now. There he is. All right, Doc.
All kinds of people, anybody you can think of. Even Vince is here.
Where? Yeah, I didn't see. Ah, there he is. Oh, look at Vince. Vince. Look at him.
Oh, yeah, Vince is definitely here.
Vince is here in a big way. Vince is here.
Vince is here in the biggest St. Louis parade ever.
Well, that's what I said before. If you're at home, please stay there because it's the traffic's a mess. You don't even want to try. It's pandemonium down here. People are getting arrested, and it's crazy. It's St. Louis loves Pete. What can we say?
It's great. It's really great.
They love him. We love him.
Yeah, and even Lori's here, and Martin.
Lori's here. Here's Lori.
Hi. How you guys? Just come down and check out the parade.
It's huge, isn't it?
Yeah, I had to park, like, way over near Union Station, take the shuttle bus.
You mean you even... I had to hitchhike down here. I couldn't even drive down
here. They have shuttle buses that are coming every half hour.
I must have missed one. I didn't know about the shuttle buses.
Right. Are they down there?
Are there a lot of guys on the shuttle bus?
Some.
Down at the fair. Mark's riding the bus all around downtown because it's going in circles.
Is that where Mark is?
Yeah, that's where Mark is. That's why he ain't here today.
I wondered where he is. He's on the bus.
Take a bus ride.
Okay. Why not? He's only missing the biggest parade St. Louis has ever seen.
That's right.
Okay, now, here, this is how big this thing is. Lori, check this out. Here comes, now this is what KDHX has got going in the parade here. This is a fashion show. This is swimwear designed by the management at KDHX, and we'd like to say thanks right now to KDHX for bringing that in.
Yeah, they've really got some a nice lineup, because you can see the young ladies, the kind of two-piece and one-piece.
I like the butt floss thing over there. Now, that's what I would wear, is that butt floss thing.
That's a
signature.
Kind of neat here.
I think it's great that everybody's here. Everybody is here. Okay, now look here. Here's more KDHX. Here's KDHX. The management from KDHX is doing the cakewalk for Pete Parisi. Look at that.
Did you ever think you'd see the day when the management of KDHX would be doing the cakewalk for PP?
It's great. A movement. It's a movement. Great. It's finally happened.
It's kind of a sign of the changing time.
It's what we've been hoping for. You know, Bill Clinton and Al Gore and Pete.
Right. And here they come.
Here they are. Oh, look at that. That's great.
It's great.
And if the swimsuit fashion show was not enough, here we have, coming down now, the beautiful women of KDHX. And KDHX has just come out in full force for this parade. This is amazing.
Well, I think, you know, the Year of the Woman, it's nice to have these women represented. They show the more feminine side of St. Louis,
sure.
And KDHX. And
yeah, and you know how...
going down the parade right now as we scan down this way.
And you know how important, you know, the beautiful woman thing is, especially with the new woman out. You know, I mean, beauty's not gone. It's not dead. It's at KDHX, obviously.
You can be smart and look nice, too.
And coming down the street now, Lori, here's another one. Is this great or what? This is a boy and his dog coming down the street here. I think that's great.
Yeah, it's Big Mike and the boy and the dog.
Who's the dog?
I forget her name, but...
We don't know the dog's name.
She looks like a nice dog.
A great dog.
Boy and his dog with his hunting exhibit.
That's great.
And they're en route, too. We have a lot of this parade. It's really diverse.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. Everybody is loving it. But really, if you're at home, don't try to come down here because it's a mess. It's really just pandemonium down here right now. So stay at home, watch it on TV, enjoy it that way. And now here comes one of my favorite people, a giant among men, the pasta doctor himself. You can tell his business is pasta. By the truck. Doc Parmalee of Mangia Italiana, one of my all-time favorite people. Laurie, do you love this guy or what?
Yeah, it makes for, like, good lasagna, best lasagna in town.
This is a party guy here. What a party dude. Hi, Doc. Good to see ya. Mwah.
Mwah.
Where's Vincent? Where's Vincent, Kathy?
I don't know. I haven't seen him. Where is Vincent?
He's so skinny, nobody can hardly pass him up.
Okay, here we go. Now, here comes Pete. Lori, look, here he comes, you guys. There's Pete. Who's it? Now, there is the Mad Russian is with him. The Mad Russian is the Grand Marshal today.
Right.
If anybody's wondering who the Grand Marshal was, it's the Mad Russian. He's there with Pete. How you doing, Pete? We're behind you. This is great. Oh, Pete looks good, doesn't he? He's got a suit on and everything.
Cut for him. Looks really
nice. Fantastic.
Yeah, and I just want to tell you about the Pete. Pete just got shot. And everybody thinks I'm a big conspiracy holder on this, but I believe it was Double Helix that was responsible for this. Definitely Double Helix was responsible, because the bullet just bounced off of Vince and shot Pete. Goodness, Pete was shot. My friend has been totally shot. I can't believe this. The bullet hit Vince and this bounced off of Vince and hit Pete right in the face, and it went through his cheek and went through his head. Oh my God, I can't believe this happened. I said, I'm glad my brother wasn't here to see Pete get shot. Oh, this is so emotionally disturbing and bad. Oh, was shot. My Goldie Dustpan's been shot.
The only hope.
It's all Vince's fault in Double Helix.
Okay. So, you've seen it? You watched it happen? Pete's dead. Probably. How did this happen, Laurie? How did this happen?
I don't know. I think it came from the window up there. I don't know. I heard a shot, and all of a sudden,
it didn't come from the window. I think it came from the grassy knoll over there. There's no hope. No hope for Double Helix. It's all over. Worldwide Magazine's all over. We can't be on TV anymore now. I wanted to be on TV. Pete, don't die, Pete.
I like working for you guys at Double Helix. Do good business. We'll have to get together on a discount sometime.
We're just about done with our show for tonight. And I was serious when I said I was running for the board of directors. But our show, as usual, was pretty silly. And I guess this is the point we've been trying to make, that a lot of the people at Double Helix take themselves way too seriously. And doing something in life isn't worth it at all unless you have fun. Unless you're able to laugh at others and yourself, enjoy yourself. And if I win the election or if I don't win, I just hope that I made that point. And I would like to tell the board, if I'm not a member of it after the election, or if I am a member of it, come on, lighten up. Stop taking yourself so seriously and have fun. So once again, this is PEP. Thanks for watching, and thanks to all the people that were silly enough to be on our show tonight, and all you people out there that were silly enough to watch it. Including you.
Yeah.
Now listen, let's go in the back room. Running out of